Hi all, now we are going to discuss on the light loss factor. So for any kind of equipment, appropriate maintenance is very essential for maintaining the system. So in order to have the same amount of lighting over the years of operation, proper maintenance is a required thing. So there are various factors which are going to affect the light output from the lamp. And there are certain factors which we can control, and there are certain factors which are out of our control. So basically the light loss factor is looking at the reduction in the initial illuminance level as the time passes on. But if proper maintenance is being carried out, then it is possible to reduce the amount of reduction in the light output. However, it is not possible to take it back to the initial stage. So, this graph is just showing the variation of light output with the years. So, here we can see that the years is increasing from 1 to 6, you can see increasing, and this is the percentage light output. So, at the initial state, it is possible to get the 100% light output. And after that, during the time passes by, the light output starts decreasing. And this shaded portion is just indicating the amount of energy which is wasted, which will be increasing with the longer maintenance intervals. So here you can see that the cleaning cycle is every 2 years. So after every 2 years, we are going to clean the system, and therefore it is possible to increase the light output to the value which is lesser than your previous one. So you can see that this particular difference is there. So the amount of maintenance frequency at which we are doing the maintenance will help to maintain a higher light output from the system. So here you can see that after 6 years or something, you can see that the decrease in the light output even after doing the maintenance is this much. So this effect of decrease in the light output, it is due to the non-recoverable reasons, and therefore we can classify the light losses as a recoverable and non-recoverable light losses. So it is not possible to make any changes on the non-recoverable factor, but it is possible to make changes in the recoverable factor by doing the proper maintenance, by the cleaning, removing the dust and everything. We can reduce the factor of the LLF, that is the light loss factor. So there are recoverable and the non-recoverable system, and under this classification, the recoverable factors will be including the luminaire dead depreciation LDD, room surface dead depreciation RSDD, lamp lumen depreciation, and lamp burnout. So these are the four factors which comes into the recoverable factors. In this, the luminaire dirt depreciation is because of the dirt accumulation on the lamps and the luminaires, on the surface of the lamp and also on the surface of the luminaire. If the dirt is getting deposited, then it is going to reduce the reflective property. So therefore, proper maintenance has to be done in order to improve the light output. So in the case of an air conditioned room, the amount of dirt which is accumulated on the luminaires will be very less when compared to an industrial area. So an AC room, it can be cleaned in a twice or thrice. Once in 2 years, you can clean the surface. But in the case of an industrial area, you may have to clean the luminaires in 6 or 7 times in a year. So it depends. And if it is a food preparation area, you can see that in our kitchen area, if you are fixing a lamp, after 1 or 2 weeks, you can see that the amount of light output is basically reduced. It is basically because the dirt is getting accumulated on the surface of that particular lamp. So luminaire dirt depreciation can be reduced by having proper maintenance of the system. Next is the room surface dirt depreciation. That is the amount of dirt which is deposited on the surface of the room, that is on the walls and on the ceilings, on the floors. So those are going to change the amount of reflectivity, which will help the light to concentrate onto the working area. So by proper cleaning of the room surfaces, it is possible to increase the reflectivity of the surface and thereby having a good light output. So the first one is luminaire dirt depreciation, that is the luminaires are being cleaned on a regular interval. Room surface net depreciation means you are going to clean the rooms such that the reflectivity is getting increased. Next is the lamp lumen depreciation and the lamp burnout LBO. So these are just inherent characteristics of the old lamps, that is the lamp lumen output will be reducing through the years of use. So you need to have a perfect relamping policy, that is after certain years of use the lamps has to be replaced with the new lamps. So it can be a spot relamping or it can be a group relamping. Spot relamping is nothing but, so in LLD you are having spot and also group. So in the case of spot relamping, when the you will be changing the lamp as and when the lamp burns out. But in the case of a group relamping, you are going to replace all the lamps in that installation at a single stretch, or it can be grouped and then you can replace in a different stretch. The spot relamping is not possible in the case of a godowns or something, because the lights are mounted at a very high heights. So you need to have certain kind of cranes in order to relamp the system. So under such conditions, they will be going for the group relamping. So even though certain lamps are working in condition, they will be changing the entire lamps in a single stretch, because it is time consuming and also cost wise it is also not effective in order to have a spot relamping in the case of a godowns or something. So it all depends upon the lamp burnout factor we are also getting considered, that is what will be the factor at which the lamps gets burned out. So that factor also takes into consideration while going for the group relamping. And the next one is the non-recoverable factors, that is out of our control, that is the luminaire ambient temperature, voltage variation, ballast factor and luminaire surface depreciation. So the certain kind of lamps has an effect on the ambient temperature, that is the operation is depending upon the ambient temperature. So we can say that the fluorescent lamps, it is basically operating at less than 30 degrees centigrade, it is best to operate. So ambient temperature is going to affect the operation of that particular lamp. Again, voltage variation. You can say that in the case of normal incandescent lamps at a house, whenever there is a high voltage, what happens is that the lamp gets burned out. Why? Because it's a filament lamp. So the filament gets burned out because of the high temperature. So variations in the temperature can result in the deterioration of the filaments and therefore it can increase the failure rate. Next is the ballast factor. So ballast factor is defined as the ratio of light output by a commercial ballast to that of a reference ballast. So if you are changing the ballast, then it may not be producing the same amount of light output as the original ballast. Next is the luminaire surface depreciation. That is the changes in the various components used in the manufacture of the luminaires can cause reduction in the light output due to the aging or due to the painting, due to the polishing of the surfaces, what are the reflectances can vary. So therefore these factors is out of our control. So we don't have any control over the non-recoverable factors, but we do have the control over the recoverable factors. That is why our graph, the light output, if you are doing the proper maintenance, it is possible to maintain the light output nearly equal to the 100%. So a small depreciation will be there, and that is because of the, so this was the actual line and it is being reduced here, and this is mainly because of the non-recoverable factors. This is the type or classification of luminaire or lighting arrangement. So basically the lighting system, it can be an upward or downward depending upon the type of application. So it will be direct, indirect, semi-direct, semi-indirect and general diffusing. Direct lighting is mainly used in our homes. Indirect lighting is being used in museums and all. Semi-direct and semi-indirect, it is again a mixed thing depending upon the applications of use. And general diffusing is that in order to reduce the effect of glare, that is that the when we are focusing our eyes directly onto the lamp, it will be irritating to our eyes, that is nothing but the glare, and therefore you need to have a general diffusing is to be required. So first we will be discussing on the direct lighting. This is nothing but the luminaire, and here you can see that this is the light output. So this is nothing but the lumen, which is directing the light output downwards. And around 90 to 100% of the light output is coming out to the lower portion, and only 10% is going to the ceiling. So this is nothing but a direct lighting scheme, and this is the most efficient. But the thing is that it can result in shadows, because the light is directly fall on our body or to the object under question. So it is mainly used for the industrial and also on the general outdoor lighting. There is a semi indirect lighting, that is around 60 to 90% of the total light is made to fall downwards, and remaining light is directed out towards the ceiling or the walls. So this is suited to rooms with high ceilings, where a high level of uniformly distributed illumination is desirable. So in the stairways, corridors and storage areas will be using semi indirect lighting. And this is an indirect lighting. Around 90% of the light flux is going to the ceiling. So it is exactly the reverse of the direct lighting. So the resulting illumination is softer and more diffused. Nowadays we are using the false ceilings, and there we are giving LED strips. So the light is not directly coming to our eyes. It is getting reflected somewhere else and then coming downwards. So, but the efficiency of the system is much lesser when compared to direct lighting, because you need to have more amount of power in order to deliver the same amount of luminous level at our workplace. This is a semi indirect. Most of the light output produced by the fittings is directed upwards, and a certain amount of light is directed downwards. So it can produce soft shadows, and it is glare free, used for indoor light decoration purposes. And this is general diffusing. Light produces equally distributed upwards and downwards. So diffusing will surely help in reducing the amount of glare. So the light distribution can be classified basically in direct, indirect, semi-direct, semi-indirect and general diffusing. And this shows the percentage of light which is going upward in each case, and the percentage of the light output going downwards. This is the general classification of the luminaire according to the degree of glare. We have this kind of classification: post-op, post-op, non-integral, cut-off, integral, cut-off, non-integral, semi-cut-off, integral, non-cut-off, tubular luminaires and floodlighting luminaires. Selection of the light sources is basically depending upon the quality and the quantity, and also the economy. So that is where the luminous flux, that is the quantity, economy, dimensions of the light source and the color characteristics. Color characteristics is looking at the quality, luminous flux is looking at the quantity, and it should be economic in nature, and the dimension should be up to our usage. So incandescent lamp, fluorescent lamp, high intensity discharge lamps. Under this we are having your mercury vapor lamp, metal halide lamp, high pressure sodium vapor lamp and low pressure sodium vapor lamp. So these are the high intensity discharge lamps, and fluorescent lamp, incandescent lamp, and what we use nowadays is nothing but the LED lamps, that is the light emitting diodes. So depending upon the type of the application, you need to select the light sources. High intensity discharge lamps is being used in the industries. Fluorescent lamps is used in the offices and in our normal working areas. That is being replaced nowadays by the LED lamps. Incandescent lamp is an obsolete one. And these are the factors to be considered for choice of the luminaire: the nature and the power of the source, optical arrangements and light distribution, that is with respect to the luminaire, how effectively it can reflect, light output ratio, that is from the luminaire how much amount of light output is being taken to the work area, whether the luminaire is an open one or a closed type. You can see the basic example is a street light, some are closed, some are open. How resistant is to heat, soiling and corrosion, because it has to be used in industrial areas. Protection against the collection of dust and insects. Atmospheric conditions. Ease of installation and maintenance. Presence or absence of auxiliaries and the fixing arrangements. That is the weight and area exposed to the wind pressure. So basically how it is very easy to use that particular luminaire is one factor. And another factor is whether it is to be used in an industrial area, whether it is in domestic area, whether it is high temperature, high wind, whether it is able to withstand it. So these are the main factors which has to be considered for selecting a particular luminaire. Thank you.